Well, a brilliant drive by young Leighton Green resulted in Jimmy Locke saluting the judge in the Golden Mile, caught up with his very delighted trainer, Joe Connolly. Well, Joe, congratulations on the win of Jimmy Locke in the Golden Mile. You've certainly joined a very illustrious honour roll with Popular Arms, certainly right up there with the very best.
Yeah, it's a quality list if you look at the winner, so it's really nice to be in a race like that and to pick it up is bonus.
It's hard to read you, Joe. You're always very cool, calm and collected, but that was an exciting performance.
Yeah, it was. You know, it was a race where we were just hoping to be competitive and go with them and see if we could be there at the end, but to run over the top and, you know, really be careering away was pretty exciting.
You've only had this fella for a short time.
We have. We've only had him in the barn for a couple of weeks, but he certainly made a good start. A couple back-to-back wins down here and, you know, he's a quality animal, so it's nice to be trusted with horses like that and get the opportunity and, you know, to reward the owners with a couple of wins has been really good.
Also a big thrill for Leighton Green securing his first Group 3 win.
Yeah, I'm really happy with him. He's a good kid. You know, he's a good kid and he's come a long way with his driving and, you know, he deserves it. So glad we gave him the opportunity and really glad that he was able to take it out.
And how did that opportunity come about?
That one was the owner's call. Obviously, there's a few regular drivers away this weekend up in Queensland, so it creates opportunities for some of the younger guys coming through, and Leighton took it with both hands. And, you know, he's one of the young drivers. I've got a couple of juniors in my barn, so I haven't really given Leighton too many opportunities, but when I've been able to put him on, he's always done a good job.
And we're in a very good position at the moment, Jay. You mentioned some of the senior drivers in Queensland, but the younger boys coming through are doing the job.
Oh, they are, you know, and he couldn't have driven that horse any better tonight. He nailed it, he assessed it, he got it exactly right, and, you know, the horse was good enough, thankfully, to reward him for his efforts on the track.
Midfield in the running line, they went hard, 27-4, 27-5 on the way home. How'd you feel?
Oh, it suited him. There was a good early burn. You know, there's a couple of quality horses in there, Alter and Cruz, and, you know, we always figured they were going to light up and we would just be able to tuck in underneath somewhere, and well, there's a solid enough tempo throughout. We felt that was our best chance to get into the race, and, you know, thankfully he was able to get the outside at the right time. Probably had to go a little earlier than we really would have liked to, but, you know, Leighton waited up and he made the right call.
Also enjoyed success early in the night, Always Rocking, and it was an outstanding drive once again, front-running drive by Robbie Morris.
Yeah, we decided to sort of roll the dice here and just be aggressive tonight, see if we could find the top. We felt if we could get there, we're a good winning chance. And Rob nailed it as well. You know, he's got a good set of hands on him, so he got to the front, let him roll along, kept the horse comfortable, and, you know, he's able to outstay them down the straight.
Can we see the name in the winner's circle again on Tuesday afternoon, the Fortunate Son in the last?
Yeah, he's back. He's sort of been a little bit inconsistent of late, and, you know, that's as much our fault as his. The weather's mucked us around a bit, trying to get a horse bigger. Big boned horse like him going, you know, it takes a lot of work to get him right, so hopefully we've got him on track for this week. I think he'll be better for the run, but I still expect him to go well this week. He's much happier at this track. We tried him at Penrith, that didn't work so well, so hopefully back on the big circuit and he'll be away and able to roll along again.
You've gotten close in a few group events previously.
Yeah, we've had a couple of goes, been knocking on the door a few times, but haven't quite managed to crack one yet, so it's good to get the monkey off the back tonight and get started. And, you know, hopefully as the team start to come back into work over the winter, we'll have a few more that are ready to race down here. Golden Year's not too far away and Archie has had his first run last night. So, you know, the team's on its way and hopefully there's more to come.
You didn't have much luck with Archie.
Nah, that's why I don't drive foul. Put it in a shocker. Look, he had to find a better spot in the race than he did, but it didn't knock him around too much. We'll have a look after him over the last few hundred and he's on track. He'll be right. He's pulled through it fine, so he'll be down here next week.
Well, Joe, as I mentioned, it's an illustrious honour roll, the Golden Mile, not only just for the horses, but with the trainers and drivers. But I can guarantee you one thing, your place in history, you're the only detective senior constable that's won the race.
That's good to know. To be fair, though, look, I should mention that Seaton's done a lot of work with these two horses. You know, they're around at his place and his barns. We share the horses between us, but, you know, he's taken full ownership of these two and worked them up, and, you know, he gets the credit for this one. He's done a good job.
Well, congratulations to all concerned, Joe, and hopefully it's the first of many.
Thanks, Mike.